where you've been able to score it. So you know how difficult it is to stay alive when your power play is not getting the job done. But one opportunity will erase all those negatives.
Giroux, Van Riemsdyk again. Sean Couturier is not available. He'd normally be in this unit. Konechny lined up over on the right side. Lone defenseman is Provorov. Islanders get the puck. Josh Bailey up to kill the penalty. Off with Jean-Gabriel Pajot. Pellick and Mayfield. Provorov leads the way. There's his drop back. Jake Voracek with some speed, a second drop. They're in over the line. Van Riemsdyk with Giroux going to the net. Throw back pass to Provorov in the blue line. He'll walk the line and send the puck over the other side. Voracek from Giroux had to take it off the boards. Looks towards the net. Thought about going up top. Now he feeds it in front for the high tip of Konechny. Couldn't get that on goal. Centering pass blindly from Giroux. Picked off and there's a 2-on-1. Pajot has Bailey going to the net. Pajot shoots up high.
Mm.
Sissikas. Pollock got nailed by Lawton, but he cleared the puck the distance. Under 40 seconds to go on the power play. Kevin Hayes drops the puck off. Sissikas doing a nice job of keeping his power play deep in its own zone. Oscar and Long. On the fly comes Matt Niskanen. Onto his back end forehand. Quick shot by Sanheim, just wide of the net. Andy Green chops at the puck along the boards. It didn't get out. Kept in. Lawton makes a pass that was knocked away by the Islanders, and they're able to clear the puck to center. Cutterbuckle. Head for the bench on change, and on comes Brock Nelson to try and kill the last 7 seconds of this penalty. Best chance came from the Islanders. Shorthanded play as opposed to Flyers getting anything accomplished at all. Lazard's back on the ice, skiing across the ice to change. 5-on-5 again. In overtime, tied 4-4. Kevin Hayes passes back to line. Here's Provorov. Screenshot. Knockdown. Puck is loose in front. And it was right behind Michael Rappley. Had no idea it was there. The Islanders are able to clean that up.
I couldn't even see Varlamov in there. So many other bodies in front of him.
Another power play without even a shot on goal. Everly is forechecking here. Carter Hart beat him on the forecheck. And the Flyers come out to center. Philip Myers has an overtime goal. Lobs the puck in. Nate Thompson. Michael Raffel. Avi Cavell is out in front of the net. He has some room. He kicks the puck up, takes the shot. Varlamov made the save with his hand, and the play is stopped.
Referee didn't see that. Yeah. The puck didn't go in. That's a break for the Islanders there, Jean-Hubert. He's saying, my fault, my fault. And here's the chance we were talking about. Watch the bodies collapsing in front of Varlamov, and you saw Mayfield fell over his back as well. That had some promise.
That shot from Provorov just wide.
Here's the one good chance right off the head of Hart, but that rebound that Bailey tried to put out in front had a chance as well. Upstairs, look at the goaltender holding his ground right off the forehead, up and over.
Tip by Konechny actually hit James Van Riemsdyk, and that's why he didn't get to the net.
Yeah, you know what? The Flyers on their power play again. It's very static and not a lot of movement of puck or body, and that one was a weak pass that was had no chance of getting there. There's Everly's Knight, the effective line. They've been dangerous when they've been out there, and Jordan Everly must feel, Jim, that he's had 4 or 5 chances to win this game alone.
He's had 12 shot attempts tonight.
There's a backhander that had some promise and in tight. The backhander that Hart made not only one, but two. And this one at the end, maybe a chance to finish the game off. Couldn't do it. Puck's been falling around, but it's the 10th game without a goal, and you can see the frustration in his face.
So to get the dry scrape. 7 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first overtime period. Islanders win tonight, or Saturday, but win tonight and they get a beat. Here's the Tampa Bay Lightning. Flyers try to score and send this to game 7. Still, they only had 3 shots in overtime, and they've had a power play on which they didn't get a shot.
Paul Giroux is 17-9 in the faceoff dots, 65%, and this is a big one here to try to get some offense out of it.
But Peugeot gets down and beats him. Pellick to the outlet. That's good stick there, knocked out of the air by Voracek at the line, so the puck stays in. Lawton is forechecking. He stole the puck from Pellick. Forced up the boards. Pellick recovers to get that puck as far as center ice, where it's shot right back in. Peugeot. Pellick up the middle. Peugeot couldn't handle the pass. But he's followed by Pellick, who dumps the puck in. Robert Hague is back with Philip Myers. Lawton up the boards to Giroux. Looks across ice. Myers has moved up as a defenseman. Got Voracek with him. Giroux's out in front of the net. Myers advances the puck around the boards. And the Flyers will change up. At center, here's Eberle again. Here's Barzal again. He goes to the net. There's the shot that was blocked. And it dies in front of the net. Derek Grant back the other way. There's Pitlick with it. Sanheim jumps up on the play. Throws the puck at the net and missed. Vaughn at the line, trying to hold the puck in. Again, Eberle with a deft little touch. Gets the puck to Matt Barzal. He moves back in. Orvilliers out front as Barzal passes him the puck. His backhander is weak and wide. Justin Braun gets the puck for Philadelphia. Moves it out to Tyler Pitlick. Van Riemsdyk falls in behind him. Pitlick squeezes by the checker tapes, but doesn't get by the second time. Barzal's back, fishing for the puck, and he's got it. This time he's got Bailey with him, Orvilliers on the wings. Up jumps Devon Taves. Bailey waits. That's blocked. He's still trying to get the puck after Provorov got the block. And the Flyers backhand the puck out to center.
Good read by Devon Taves. He joined the rush there, but it was 4 deep. If that shot hadn't been blocked and gone the other way, it was trouble.
Here's Kevin Hayes back with Michael Rappel. Connecting the centering pass. Harmlessly drifted to the boards, and Brock Nelson is back. He shoots the puck in for Matt Martin to go out here. Martin taken out by Niskanen. On comes Cizikas and Clutterbuck. To get the puck back in, they do. For a moment, Niskanen on the boards, coming back with the puck is Raffel. And he clears it out to center. That's Konechny who has it. Moves it on the defense, and he can't get by that in color. And so that play dies on the defenseman's stick. Out to center, Matt Martin with a shooting. Quick shift and off. Justin Braun is back for the puck. Robert Hayne, checked by Leo Komarov. On the center, Oscar Lindblom had the puck taken away by Nicolay. From behind the net, Islander skate to center. Here's Brassard. You know, the defensive backhand shot, an easy save for Carter Hart, and he covers up with 4.5 minutes to go in this first overtime period.
A little end-to-end action, and the guys you would expect to create it were doing some. Barzal tried to get a shooting lane by curl and drag there, and the Sandheim does a great job with his stick. And then on the curl, the back with traffic in front, never a bad thing, as once again, another block that Provorov keeps it away from his goaltender.
Islanders come back with Barzal for a faceoff in the attacking zone. He's after the puck. Myers got it, cleared it down the ice, and this will be an icing call against Philadelphia. So another big face.